Good morning, dear students. Welcome back to the class. We are studying our lesson number 1, that is rational numbers. Okay, so our lesson is rational numbers. Okay, in which we are studying about the multiplication. Okay, we are studying about the multiplication and we have completed up to the question number 9 of which exercise 1C, question number 9 we have completed. Okay, so I hope you all completed this exercise in your notebook. Now I am telling you the question number 10. Okay, so which exercise 1C. Which question? Question number 10. We are taking question number 10. What is your question number 10? Verify the property A multiply with B multiply with C is equal to A multiply with B multiply with C. When A is, there are two questions, okay? So I will solve one question and the second question is the homework for you. Okay, तो आपको क्या करना है? वो बोल रहा है कि आपको इसमें associative property verify करनी है. Because in the associativity property, what we have to do? We change the grouping of numbers and in this case, in both the cases, our answer remains same. So we have to check it for the two different types of values of A, B, C. Okay, and I will told you in all the previous lectures, if there is a question of a verification, first find out the value of LHS and after that find out the value of RHS. Okay, but before that, write your values. What is the value of A? What is the value of A? A is equals to 7 upon 13. B is equals to 1 upon 7 and C is equals to minus 13 upon 15 and we have to verify the associative property. So LHS is equals to A multiply with B multiply with C. Okay, this is your question. I only write question here. Now you have to put the value of A, B, C here. First of all, put the value of A, B, C here. Okay? So LHS is equals to A, 7 upon 13 multiply with 1 upon 7 multiply with minus 13 upon 15 multiply with minus 13 upon 15. Okay, so you have to multiply it. Okay, so multiply your numerator with the numerator. Multiply numerator with the numerator. So your numerator becomes 1 multiply with minus 13, 1 multiply with minus 13, and in the denominator 7 multiply with 15, and in the denominator 7 multiply with 15. Now check. Is there any number get cancelled? क्या यहाँ ऐसे कोई भी numbers आपको दिख रहे हैं जो एक दूसरे से cancel होने वाले हैं? But there is no number that get cancelled. So we write it as 7 upon 13 multiply with 1 multiply with minus 13 and in the denominator it is 7 into 15. क्योंकि यहाँ पे कोई भी नंबर कैंसिल नहीं हो रहा था तो हमने कैंसिल नहीं किया है और नेक्स्ट स्टेप में हमने इनका जो मल्टीप्लिकेशन था उसको मल्टीप्लाई किया हमारे फर्स्ट टर्म से. ओके, सो नाउ यू कैन राइट इट एज इज इक्वल टू 7 into 1 multiply with minus 13 and in the denominator it is 13 multiply with 7 multiply with 15. Now your 13 get cancelled with this 13, okay, by minus 1 and here 1, and 7 get cancelled with 7 and your answer is in the numerator 1 into 1 into minus 1 and in the denominator it is 1 into 1 into the denominator it is 15. This is your LHS. This is the value of your LHS. Now we are finding the value of RHS. Okay. So what is your RHS? Your RHS is again equals to what is your RHS? What is your RHS? Your RHS is A multiplied with B and multiplied with C. A multiplied with B and multiplied with C. Okay? You know what is Bod mass rule. Okay? So, in the Bod mass rule, you have to first solve the bracket. Okay? So, we are solving the bracket here. That is, first put the value, that is 7 upon 13 multiplied with 1 upon 7 and it is multiplied with minus 13 upon 15. Okay? So here 7 is cancelled with 7 by 1 and 1. So you can write it as 1 multiplied by 1 and in the denominator 13 multiplied by 1 and it multiplied with minus 13 upon 15. Okay, minus 13 upon 15. Okay, so 1 into 1 is 1 and in the denominator it is 13 and it multiplied with minus 13 upon 15. So you can write it as 1 multiplied with minus 13 and in the denominator it is 13 multiplied with 15. So you can cancel out 13, that is 13 moves are 13 and here the minus 1. So your answer is 1 into minus 1, 1 into minus 1 and in the denominator 1 into 15. So your answer is minus 1 upon 15 for the LHS and the same answer we are getting for the LHS. यही सेम आंसर हमें LHS के लिए मिला था और यही सेम आंसर हमें RHS के लिए मिला था। पहले देख लो मैं एक स्टेप में क्या है, फर्स्ट वी राइट द क्वेश्चन, देन वी पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ A, B एंड C. आफ्टर दैट वी आर पुटिंग द वैल्यूज फॉर A, B एंड C. ओके, सो हियर द 7 गेट कैंसिल, हियर द 1 7 इज इन द न्यूमरेटर एंड द सेकंड 7 इज इन द डिनोमिनेटर, सो वी कैन कैंसिल बाय राइटिंग 1 एंड 1 here. Okay, so the, your numerator becomes 1 into 1 and denominator is 13 into 1. Okay, so after that 1 into 1 is 1 and 13 into 1 is 13 multiplied by minus 13 upon 15. Now we write it as 1 into minus 13 in the numerator and 13 into 15 in the denominator. Now 13 ones are 13 and 13 into minus 1 is equal to minus 13. So your numerator becomes 1 into minus 1 and in the denominator 1 into 15. So 1 into minus 1 is minus 1 and in the denominator it is 15. So your LHS is equal to RHS. And what is your LHS? Your LHS is A multiplied with B multiplied with C and your RHS is A multiplied with B multiplied with C and hence very. And hence very. Okay, so in this way you have to solve your question number 2 also. Okay, and question number 11 is also same, so try to solve. Okay, and now I am solving the question number 12. Now I am solving the question number 12 because question number 11 is same as the question number 10, but there is a distributive property. You have to prove there the distributive property. So I am taking the question number 12. A, the cost of 1 meter of cloth is rupees 16.7/3. अगर 1 meter कपड़े का जो price है वो है 16.7/3. So find the cost for 9/11 meters. अगर हमें किसी भी cloth का पता होता कि ये इतने rupees का है, 1 अगर मैं बोलूँ आपको कि if 1 pencil is offer 20 rupees, then you can find out the value of a 5 pencils. Okay. वन पेंसिल, एक पेंसिल जो है 20 रुपए की है, अगर मैं आपको बोलूँ 5 पेंसिल की प्राइस निकालना, यू विल मल्टीप्लाई योर प्राइस विद 5. इन द सेम वे ये द 1 मीटर क्लॉथ का आपको प्राइस दिया तो आपको 9/11 मीटर का निकालना है, तो आपका जो भी प्राइस है अगर आप उसे 9/11 से मल्टीप्लाई करोगे तो आपका आंसर आ जाएगा. सो राइट द सॉल्यूशन. Write the solution here. Cost of 1 meter cloth. Cost of 1 meter cloth. Cost of 1 meter cloth is equals to ₹16.7/3. Okay, this value is in the improper mixed fraction. This value is in a mixed fraction. So first convert your price in the improper fraction. जो आपको value दी गई है वो mixed fraction है, ठीक है? ये जो 16/7/3 है, ये आपका mixed fraction है. So first convert this mixed fraction into an improper fraction. So if you are converting it, what will be your value? 16 × 48 + 7, that is 55/3. So the cost of 1 meter cloth is 15/3. So what is your question? Your question is find the cost of 9/11 meters cloth. So cost of 9/11 meters cloth. Okay, 9/11 meters cloth. Okay, so it is equals to 55/3 multiplied with 9/11. Now cancel out. 11 ones are 11. 11 5s are 55. 3 ones are 3 and 3 3s are 9. So in the numerator 5 × 3 and in the denominator 1 × 1. So you can write ₹15 here. That means the cost of 9/11 meters cloth is equals to 15. So you have to write in the last hands the cost of 9/11 meters cloth is ₹15. Okay, so this is your solution for question number 12. Okay, now what is question number 13? Question number 13 is a car is moving with a uniform speed of 79/3 km/h. वो बोल रहा है कि एक कार जो है वो यूनिफॉर्म स्पीड, मतलब सेम स्पीड से मूव कर रही है, बट उसकी जो स्पीड है वो क्या है, 79/3 km/h. किलोमीटर पर आवर मीन्स एक घंटे में वो इतना किलोमीटर चलता है. कितना किलोमीटर चलता है? 1 आवर में वो कवर करता है 79/3 km. ठीक है, 79/3 km/h स्पीड का मतलब ये होता है कि 1 आवर में हम 79/3 km डिस्टेंस कवर कर रहे हैं. सो फाइंड द डिस्टेंस कवर्ड बाय द कार इन द 9 आवर्स. देन यू हैव, अगर एक घंटे में 79/3 km कवर कर रहे हैं तो आपको निकालना है कि 9 आवर्स में कितना करेंगे. तो हम जो गिवन वैल्यू है उसे किससे मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे? 9 से. सो राइट द सॉल्यूशन हियर फॉर योर क्वेश्चन नंबर 13. ओके, सॉल्यूशन फॉर द क्वेश्चन नंबर 13 इज डिस्टेंस covered in 1 hour is equal to 79/3 km. So the distance covered, so the distance covered in how many hours? In 9 hours is equals to 79/3 multiplied with 9. Okay, itna kilometer. So here there is no denominator, that is 79/9, and in the denominator it is 3 × 1. So 3 ones are 3 and 3 3s are 9. So what will be your distance? 3 9s are 27. Okay. 37 × 21 = 237 km. You don't need to write denominator here because in the denominator that is there is a 1 × 1 that is equals to 1, and if there is a denominator in the 1 you can skip it. So in the last we have to write hence the distance covered in 9 hours is 237 kilometers. That means if in the question the value for one unit is given, you can find out the value for any multiple of it. Okay, अगर आपको 1 meter cloth का price दिया है तो आप 9 meters का निकाल सकते हो, 9/11 meters का निकाल सकते हो, 15 meters का निकाल सकते हो। ठीक, अगर आपको 1 meter का price दिया तो आप किसी का भी price निकाल सकते हो, ठीक है, कितने भी meters का। इन द सेम वे अगर आपको क्वेश्चन में बताया कि आप 1 घंटे में कितना किलोमीटर जा सकते हो, तो आप ये निकाल सकते हो कि आप 2 hours में कितना डिस्टेंस कवर कर सकते हो या 5 hours में कितना। तो आपको अगर मल्टीप्लीकेशन कब अप्लाई होते हैं, जब 1 unit की वैल्यू गिवन होती है और आपको मल्टीपल की निकालनी होती है, तो हम क्या यूज करते हैं, वी यूज द मल्टीप्लीकेशन देयर। ओके, सो दिस इज द सॉल्यूशन फॉर द क्वेश्चन नंबर 12 एंड दिस इज द सॉल्यूशन फॉर द क्वेश्चन नंबर 13। सो यू हैव टू सॉल्व एक्सरसाइज 1C इन योर नोटबुक। कंप्लीट द एक्सरसाइज 1C as soon as possible, because our next topic, it is division of rational numbers, we are taking in the next lecture, and there is an exercise based on this. So before starting of exercise 1, we complete 1C in your notebook. Okay, so complete it, practice well, take care, bye.